I read, the words on the page like move. So like as I stare at it, sometimes it'll swirl or like letters will fall out of words or words will even just like run off the page. Then when you go to write, you mix up your letters and the sounds they make. B's, P's, Q's, R's, W's, 9's, some numbers are thrown in the mix as well. I struggled with reading ever since I was learning to read, but it wasn't until I was in sixth grade when my mom, who's a special ed teacher, was working with my brother. And he's like, "Mom, I can't read because the words keep moving." And I looked at him and I go, "Buddy, they're always gonna do that. You just have to squint and turn your head and they stop a little bit so you can make the words out." Figured out I was a little dyslexic. It's frustrating in school, so like, we use like a letter system to like distinguish where you were at in reading. I was always lower than all of my classmates, or like sometimes you get into group work and you can kind of just tell that you're not in the smart group. The teacher's always working with you while everybody else is working on their own. Things like that, working you through things. There's always just extra help and you can tell. I struggled with math more and like looking at numbers, learning to write them, things like that. And then when I got to algebra and they decided to throw letters into the mix, that was really confusing. X's and multiplication signs, just other letters that look similar. Sometimes like, and when you get to calculus, they use T's for things. That was really bad. I had to learn how to write my letters differently so I could distinguish them from different math signs. It does take me longer, I think, just because I have to double check everything. So like if I'm doing math, I have to go through everything more than once to make sure I have like the numbers in the right spot, or like I typed it into my calculator right, things like that. Writing, it takes me a long time to get my ideas onto the paper. So I'll have like some really good ideas in my head, but I don't always know the words to describe what I'm thinking. The moving of the letters on the page is, it's tied in with dyslexia. Most people have both of them, so it's usually grouped as one. It's technically called scotopic sensitivity syndrome, and that it's really similar. That's why most people just group it into the same thing. So I read with a purple overlay. I have it on my computer screen with like an extension there where I can put it over like if I'm reading an online textbook or e-learn or anything like that. And then I have hard copies that basically just, they're like a translucent, like purple sheet of paper that you put over top that like you can read like papers, textbooks, things like that. Then you put the purple on it and that stops the like the moving of the words. So the words aren't gonna fall off the page anymore, but you're still gonna mix them up in like the sounds they make. It's not as much of an issue anymore because I've learned different strategies to deal with it. But still, sometimes when I'm reading, I'll get a headache or whatever. Some days are better than others. When I'm really stressed out, it gets worse. Sometimes, like when I'm texting my friends, they get messages that they can't really understand, things like that, especially if I don't proofread all my stuff. Writing essays, I always have to have somebody check over my grammar, my spelling, things like that.